everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video we are going to discuss about this projection formula. Now first of all we have to know what is this projection formula means. Here in this projection formula we are going to represent these three dimensional structures in two dimensional drawings, that is representation of three dimensional structures into two dimensional drawings is nothing but this projection formula. Now there are four types of this representation. The first one is flying wedge representation, second one is Fisher projection formula, and third one is Sawhorse formula, and fourth one is Newman projection. These are the four types of this projection formula. Now let's discuss one by one. Now coming to the first one, that is flying wedge representation. Now in this representation, three types of lines are used in a standard way to indicate three-dimensional structure in two-dimensional picture. See this first point. In this representation, we are using three types of lines to indicate this three-dimensional structure into two-dimensional structure. Let's study what are these three types of lines. Here, the first type of line is solid wedge. We can call it as a thick line. It is like this. The first one is solid wedge. And the second one is a solid line. See here, it is a continuous line like this. And the third one is dashed lines. See here, these are the dashed lines. These are the three types of lines which are used in a standard way to indicate these three dimensional structures into two dimensional structure. Now let us see what is the use of these lines in this flying wedge representation. Now let us take the example of this glyceraldehyde to understand this flying wedge representation. So here I have shown you flying wedge representation of two forms of glyceraldehyde. So here you can see that here is a thick line and here is a solid line, or we can also say that it is a continuous line, and here is a broken wedge or it is a dashed lines. So here first coming to the thick line, this thick line represent a bond projecting above the plane of a paper. See here, it is a plane of a paper. If a bond projects above the plane of a paper, such type of a bond is represented by this thick line. We can also call it as a solid wedge. So the bond projecting above the plane of paper, see here, it is a plane of a paper. If it is a bond and this bond is projecting above the plane of a paper, we are using this solid wedge to represent this type of bond. And we can also say that this bond is projecting towards the observer. And second type of line is a continuous lines. Here is a continuous lines, or we can also call it as solid lines. These are the bonds in the plane of a paper. See here, this is a plane of a paper. These bonds are in the plane of a paper like this. And so here, these are the bonds projecting, not projecting, these are the bonds in the plane of a, in the plane of paper. And third type of line is a broken wedge. We can also call it as a dashed lines. Here in this, a bond is below the plane of a paper. We can also say a bond is pointing away from the observer. See here, this is a dashed lines. This is below the plane. So it is a plane of a paper. If the bond is projecting below the plane of a paper, so then these type of lines, that is dashed lines, are used to represent them. Or we can also say this bond is pointing away from the observer. Bond is, this bond is below the plane of paper. Now coming to the second type of projection, that is Fisher projection formula. In this Fisher projection, all the bonds are drawn in the solid lines. But you should understand that these horizontal bonds, see here, these horizontal bonds, that is both left and right, point towards the observer. So this is the horizontal bond. So these are the horizontal bonds. These bonds are pointing towards the observer. Towards the observer. Or we can also say these are the bonds which are projecting above the plane of a paper. So these and this bond is projecting above the plane of a paper. See here, this is a plane of a paper. These bonds are projecting above the plane of a paper like this. And you can see these vertical bonds are pointing away from the observer. See here, these are projecting away from the observer. We can also say that means these are below the plane. Here is a plane of a paper and these bonds are projecting below the plane of a paper. Here is a chiral carbon. This chiral carbon atom lies in the plane of a paper. You should know that this chiral carbon atom lies in the plane of a paper. This horizontal bonds are towards the observer, that is above the plane, and these vertical bonds are away from the observer, that is they are below the plane. Now coming to the source formula. In this source formula, the source formula indicates the spatial arrangement of all the atoms or groups on two adjacent carbon atoms. So here I have taken the example of this ethane. Ethane consists of two conformations, that is staggered conformation and eclipsed conformation. See the structural difference between this staggered conformation and the eclipsed conformation. Here, coming to the definition of the Swartz formula. See here, it indicates the arrangement of all the atoms or groups on two adjacent carbon atoms. These are the carbon atoms. So here, the arrangement of all the atoms or groups are indicated in this Swartz formula. Now coming to this structure, see here this staggered structure. Here the bond between the adjacent carbon atoms is represented by a diagonal line. See here is a diagonal line. Here is a carbon atom and here is a carbon atom. The bond between these two adjacent carbon atoms is represented by a diagonal line. We can see it here. Here this line is usually from the lower left to upper right. See here, lower left to upper right. The important point is that the left and bottom end represent the atom which is nearest to the observer. See here, this left and bottom end, that is this is the left and bottom end. This represent the atom nearest to the observer. So here it is nearest to the observer. Here now the right hand top end, the atoms are farther away. So these atoms are farther away from the observer. So once again, let's see what we have studied in this Swartz formula. See here, this Swartz formula, which indicates the arrangement of all the atoms or groups on two adjacent carbon atoms. These are the two adjacent carbon atoms. Here the groups or atoms which are attached to the adjacent carbon atoms. These adjacent carbon atoms are joined together by a diagonal line, which is usually from lower left to the upper right. Here the left and bottom end represent the atom which is nearest to the observer. Here in the right hand top end, the atoms which are farther away from the observer. Coming to the Newman projection. Here, similar to the Swartz formula, Newman projection represents the spatial arrangement of all the atoms or groups on two adjacent carbon atoms. See, here we have taken the example of ethane. Once again, so it is the staggered conformation of ethane and this is eclipsed conformation. This staggered conformation is more stable than the eclipsed conformation. Let's consider the formula of this ethane. We know that it is C2H6. First of all, we have to know where are the two carbon atoms located in this Newman projection. See here, the carbon towards the front is represented by a dot. So this dot is a front carbon. A dot is nothing but a front carbon. And for a front carbon, you can see the groups which are attached. Here is the hydrogen and here is the hydrogen and here is the hydrogen. Here you can see a circle here. So this circle is another carbon. That is, it is a rear carbon, which is behind this front carbon. So here this dot is a front carbon and this circle is a rear carbon. For a dot, these are the groups. That means for a front carbon, these are the groups which are attached to the front carbon. And for a circle, you can see these are the groups which are attached for a circle. Here in this staggered conformation of ethane, the angle between these two hydrogen atoms is 60 degree. And in the eclipsed conformation, this hydrogen atom which is on the rear carbon is directly behind a hydrogen on the front carbon. So the angle between these two is 0 degree. Why? Because this rear hydrogen is behind the front hydrogen. This is about the four types of projection formula. Thank you for watching.